If you have hearing loss, you could soon buy a hearing aid without needing to have an exam, a prescription, or a special fitting first. In a move that apparently was years in the making, the FDA has issued a final ruling allowing over-the-counter sales of hearing aids to adults with mild or moderate hearing loss. They could be available as soon as October when that rule takes effect.
And joining us on the KOGO News Live Line, Paul Seegert, managing partner at PCS Advisors, a health benefits consulting firm. Good to have you back, Paul.
Thank you. Glad to be with you.
So first of all, the million-trillion-dollar question is, why doesn't Medicare cover the cost of hearing aids?
Well, there are simply things that there aren't enough dollars in the program to cover. And this is one of them that was considered something that seniors would have to do on their own, much like dental care. And so this is really good news, since the average retail price a couple of years back even was north of $2,000, and 84% of that market was controlled by just a few companies. They had not a monopoly, but close to it on that business.
Why has it taken so long to do this? I mean, this has been an issue for a long time. Both Ted and I have, obviously, you know, older parents who have needed hearing aids, and we've spent a fortune making that happen.
Yeah, it comes down to so many things that slow down change in our system. The industry has been working really hard to protect their market through lobbying and so on. In fact, in the prior administration, the law that has led to this now ruling was passed and signed, and they managed to delay it this long through effective...
Are you there?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, you're cutting in and out a little bit.
Yeah, sorry about that. So now the average price of a hearing aid is about $2,300. Do you think this we'll see a drop in price because of this?
We're going to have more competition, and it will lead to higher quality and lower cost, like we've seen in other parts of the market where parents not involved in the payment model, and you have real free market forces going on. If you look at things like LASIK surgery as an example, quality has gone up and cost has gone down. And I expect we'll see the same thing happen here with similar market forces.
Now, is the key here mild or moderate hearing loss?
Well, folks are going to have access to the same types of hearing aids that they used to would need a prescription for in the past, consultation. So it seems to me that they're opening the way for all kinds of folks to get hearing aids more affordably, even if they have more significant hearing loss. And we have people in this country that have foregone hearing aids, even though they need them and do have significant hearing loss, because cost. I think it's estimated around a million Americans need aids and don't currently have them.
All right. Paul Seegert, managing partner of PCS Advisors, with us here on the KOGO News Live Line. Thanks. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me. Have a great day.